Video Waves has been a pioneer and a major player in the audiovisual space for the last two decades. What originally started off as a videography and photography house 30 years ago, you know, as time flew, they became a major player in the video technology and conference audio sphere as well, keeping alive the original photography and videography traditional verticals too, of course. A solid partner to many of us event managers across the country, Video Waves and their reliable team have been the backbone of many successful events across India. The always flexible and accommodative attitude of the team, along with the latest tech, is a sure shot combination for a reliable vendor partner we have found in them. Well, thank you, Kunalji, for having all of this for the industry folks. I'm glad this has become a tradition. You know, year on year, we're doing these. Earlier, we used to do them in person. Now it's become a webinar. And I think we should do these more often because digital is the future for all of us. Well, further, we also have a very special guest here on the show today, who's also a legend in his own right, Mr. Suresh Madan, founder of Dynamics Media Solutions Delhi. Welcome, Suresh ji. Over to you, Kunal ji.
So, display devices, for a small presentation, if we're talking to a small group, then even a laptop is fine if you're addressing two people. But we need a larger display device when we're addressing any kind of a gathering, a meeting, maybe about 8, 10 people, 20 people, 50, 100 people. So we need different display devices when we need to cater to larger audiences. So we need to understand for what kind of audience, and there are so many parameters by which we'll decide the kind of display device to use for any particular meeting. Now, this is the first question that we had, and this is an example of the LFD screen, which is the last large format display. You also, some people call this the LCD or the video wall, it is called. It is also called the seamless plasma. So essentially, it's a combination of different monitor sets placed vertically, horizontally, and a combination of all. So here the main point for this is that the border or the bezel of the screen is usually between 3 to 6 mm. So when we combine these, we can get we can make any larger or customized image. They can be mounted in multiple numbers vertically, horizontally. They are mainly used in offices and exhibitions for very close viewing. See, we've got So here the main advantage is if we have a very small image and still we need high resolution, then see each unit will usually give us an HD resolution. So even in a very small unit, we can actually have your full 1920 by 1080 resolution. And this is just like your television. So we can go as close as we want to this and there will be no pixelation as such. Otherwise, for an LED wall, we need to maintain a certain distance. For projection, we need distances. But for LED, we can go as close as we want. So this is another way in which the LFD screen can be placed to get, you know, the desired result. Of course, the fabrication for each format will have to be customized the way we want it, but and the fabrication will have to be done accordingly.
Kunalji, we have a quick question coming in this regard from Tushar Tavre. Yes. How can we achieve a 16:9 ratio in an LFD? Can we use any splitting processors or make multiple displays?
Okay, I'll tell you. This is a good valid question at this point. So each LFD by default is a 16:9 ratio. So when we do a 2x2, the example that you see on your left is a 2x2. So when we maintain 2x2 or a 3x3, it becomes a default 16:9 ratio. So if we are not doing 2x2 or 3.3 or, you know, those kind of multiples, then it will become a customized this. So if you've got, say, we've got three vertically and say maybe four vertically, three horizontally or something, or we just have, you know, three vertically, two, then it becomes more of a square. So then it becomes something like a 1:1. So any different combination that we're doing, it will be a customizing. Otherwise, by default, a 2x2, 3x3 or a 4x4, we'll all be in 16:9 ratio.
So guys, anything in a 1:1 ratio with equal number of panels vertically and horizontally will automatically come into a 16:9 ratio.
Display device. This is one of the most conventional devices we've been using for years and we will keep using it.
Sorry, before you go on to this, a quick question from Uchit Mehta. What is the size of each LFD panel? You know, as far as I know, each panel, there are different panels of different sizes, right, Kunalji? So if you can put some light on any standard size that we go with, any thumb rule?
Yes, standard sizes are about 46 inches diagonal. And when we see, you say 46 inches diagonal, it is more or less about 3.5 feet wide and 2 feet in height.
Right. You know, while you also shared the large screen, there are also those standees you shared. If you can just go back to that image a couple of slides behind. You know, there's a question from Mufaddal. In which scenario would a LFD setup be much better than LED standees, you know, comparatively?
Yes. The resolution of LFD is much more. Like if you see these, now left to right, each panel is giving us your 1920. And So if your standees will give us pixels of in from left to right, say about 225, 250 pixels, whereas your left to right pixels, you're getting full 1920. So if we are combining four of these, then your height is 1080. So total height for this is, you know, 1080 into four. So more than 4000 pixels in height, and your width is almost about 1920. So this is something like a 2K horizontal and a 4K vertical. So the amount of content that you can put in this is, you know, much, much more than you can put in a standee. But a standee is very convenient, easy to install and easy to use. Whereas here, we'll need the support and fabrication and all of these. But yes, you know, in terms of resolution, there is nothing to beat an LFD.
Absolutely. You know, also in regard to this, a quick question from Kunal Rathore. How do we provide the artwork if we are moving out of the 16:9 ratio? So while you mentioned that if we're doing an LFD wall, which is in a 16:9 ratio, you know, we understand what artwork to give. But if it's not, then how would we calculate it? In pixels or in sizes? How exactly would it work?
Yeah, in pixels. So just as I mentioned for this, your width is 1920 and height is, you know, 1080 into 4. So which makes it 4,832. So 4,320 pixels. So, you know, this content would can be made in those kind of pixels.
Right. And so I hope Laksh, that answers your question as well. Another quick one. Oh, you know, what are the, any particular precautions for LFD for indoor or outdoor insulation? So this is from Praveen Soni. Praveen, LFDs are definitely not for outdoor insulation. They are for indoor insulation. Any precautions, Kunalji, that you have to take while installing these?
These are very delicate. So, you know, any kind of an impact will put a crack on the screen. So they need to be well protected and covered. Otherwise, they are really very delicate. And if you go to any of the, you know, rental company warehouses, there are so many LED TVs and LFDs which will be broken or cracked. So that is one of the main precautions, that, you know, it needs to be handled very carefully and placed in such a way that there is no impact.
Great, thank you so much.
Otherwise, usually, you know, the LFDs are wall mounted, but if you want to put it in the middle, then these are the kind of fabrication structures. Otherwise, usually LFDs are wall mounted.
Okay.
So coming to projectors, there are many, many kinds of projectors which are available. So how do we select the right projector? There are a number of parameters by which we can choose the projector for our particular event or application. So understand, so how does the projector help us? Projector is, you know, it can give us the largest possible image at a shorter distance. Smaller images are also a good option with the projectors. They're much lower in cost. They are space saving, easy to carry and install. I'm sure everyone understands these features.
Right. Sorry, I'm going to interrupt you again. There are a lot of questions coming in on the LFD, since a lot of us don't have so much knowledge on the LFD. You know, quick question, do these LFD panels get heated if they are mounted in standees for a long time? Is there a heat issue?
No, because this is like your television. So there is not much of a heat issue, but of course we need to have provision for, you know, ventilation from the other side. It cannot be completely packed, because for any electronic equipment, there is heat emission. So we need to keep provision for that.
Right. Quick one from Santosh Manikandan. Why is it always difficult to match color quality if you use more than four or six screens in an LFD? Well, typically how we used to have issues with plasma screens earlier, you know, in one space, in terms of matching the quality, the tonal quality. So why is this an issue? Is it because people don't have the inventory, or is there any other technical issue?
Santosh is a good friend from Delhi, and we've been working for donkey years. Hi, Santosh. And yeah, for LFD to be able to get the correct colors, it is very essential that you know, all the LFDs should have been bought at one time and used for the same number of hours, which in the rental market or scenario becomes very difficult. So it is more about the wear and tear. And as you keep using, just like projectors, the way Raghav said that, you know, you use two projectors for 200 hours and the other two projectors, even if we bought them together, and if we use the other two projectors for 500 hours, and then for certain event, if we try to match them, we'll not get them 100% matching.
So typically it depends on the number of running hours and the maintenance. Quick one, last question on the LFD I'm taking. Is there a curved option when it comes to the LFD walls?
Curved LFDs, not to my knowledge. We have the curved screens, but curved LFDs with a seamless bezel, I'm not the right person to answer. I'm not at least familiar with that.
Right. And is there any maximum size that you can go up to in an LFD in terms of, especially when you're calculating the pixels, there must be some outer size you can do, right?
What I've seen is, you know, we've seen something like a 6x6 is something that we've seen.
So typical, what sort of resolution would a wall like that be at?
If you are playing at 100% resolution, then 6 LFDs left to right is almost like 12,000 pixels left to right, and 6 vertically is almost about 6,000 pixels. So,
wow.
So that would be like, you know, a very, very huge LED screen. So essentially LFDs can give us much higher resolution than our LED walls. The standard 2.9, 3.9, if you are comparing, LFDs can give us very, very high resolutions.
Right. Okay, guys, last question on LFD here. You know, is there any particular brand of LFDs that are preferred by, you know, by vendors like yourself, by partners like yourself?
Samsung, LG are the popular brands, but we're not very brand specific. Samsung has a very good market share when it comes to standard screens.
Great. So I hope that answers your question, Chirag, and we will now move on to projection.
And initially, we were considering, Raghav, whether to have the subject of LFD or not, and see the number of questions.
Yeah, yes, I am surprised, actually. That's excellent, because personally for me, and you know, for some people I know, the LFD installation has always been quite a tough task. Unless it's in an expo, which is being used for more than 3 to 5 days, then it's something which is really beneficial.
So moving ahead with projectors, as I said, the parameters, you know, choosing the right projector depends upon the screen size, the brightness of the projector that we need, the resolution. So what resolution projector we need, right from our XGA, which is 1024x768 Cell AK. We also have 4K projectors. Then it depends upon the audience size, the ambient lighting on that venue, and the kind of distance that we have between the projector and the screen determines the kind of lens that we need to use with the projector. Now, we start with small meeting rooms. Small meeting room typically would have a screen size of about 6x4.5 or 7x4. These are, you know, 6x4.5 is your 4:3 ratio, 7x4 more or less is your 16:9 ratio. So when we have two sizes, it will mean the two ratios. Your brightness could be around 2500 to 4000 lumens. Doesn't mean that you can't use a 6000 or 8000 lumens, but it would be an overkill. So these are the recommended things. But again, as Raghav mentioned, these are all very subjective. And for this kind of a screen size, about, you know, 10 to 30 people audience, it would suffice.
But, you know, another observation I have, Kunalji, is that, you know, people are still, when they're talking to suppliers or partners like yourself, they are still referring to 4:3 ratios when it comes to standard projection screens. Have you noticed this as well? People will always say 6x4, 8x6, 8x10, 10x12. You know, we have to understand that it can also be in an HD format, right? Because most of the presentations and content today are made in a 16:9 ratio. So typically, are all your projectors at this point equipped to, you know, kind of project in that particular aspect ratio?
Yes, all the projectors have the option of 4:3, 16:9. Of course, the native resolution of the projector could be different. So if it's a native 4:3 ratio, then it can adjust, it can accommodate 16:9 and vice versa. But yes, most of the projectors can work with both the aspect ratios. Mm.
You know, there's a question from Gaurav Jain, and it's a very valid question for many people who are not so much into this. How is the right projector selected as per the screen size? You know, how do we know what is the right projector? Yes, is there a rule of thumb to something like this?
There is no rule of thumb. So so that is why we are defining the broad. Let us take up this projection thing. And then if we feel that you know, something is not covered, then we'll take the questions.
Absolutely.
So for something like an 8x6 or 8x4.5 screen, we could use anything between, if it's a very dark, if there is not too much light, we could even do with a 3000 lumens, but ideally about 5 or 6000 lumens would be recommended. And 50 to 100 people audience should be good for that kind of an audience. Then for larger events, maybe about 10x7.5 or 11x6, 5000 to 8000 lumens and 100 plus people. Also, we could have, you know, multiple projectors and delay screens depending upon the audience size and the distance that you have between the screen and the audience. So this is an example where you have your two side screens and then you have your delay plasmas. Yeah, this is again, projectors have been used for, it is very rare these days that for conferences, but here you can see there are three projectors which have been flown from a truss. And this image is about 50 feet by 16 feet where multiple projectors are used along with watch out and edge blending to give this kind of a good image with excellent saturation. These projectors, even for this event, were borrowed from my good friend Suresh Madan for one of the conferences that we had done.
So can you tell us what was the intensity of these projectors?
These were 20,000 lumens projectors.
Right. No, so I think it's important for people to know here, Kunalji, that projection is never really going to go out of fashion, you know, because especially when you're doing international conferences with a lot of content, I think, you know, seamlessly edge blending all these projectors is really an art. And it's something that I think is never really going to go out. It's something that's always going to be there, especially for international conferences. The sort of clarity and the sort of softness you get on a projector is unmatched. Is that right?
Absolutely. I agree with you totally. The kind of softness and the fine image that we'll get with projectors, we'll never be able to achieve that with the LED wall, whatever, you know, howsoever a fine pitch that we do. So earlier it was that agar projector, it was about budgeting. Now, if it's a very premium event, then only then you will have projectors. Otherwise, if it's a premium event, you would think of it in terms of an LED. Now, if it's a very premium event, then you will have this kind of a
projector. Absolutely. Unfortunately, it's taken a full 360 degree circle. Life has come a full circle. And now projection is far more expensive than actually doing LED.
Yes. And as we have Suresh on board, anything, you know, something very typically about these kind of high lumens projectors or something, if we have any of those questions, I'm sure Suresh will be able to guide us better with these questions for very high brightness projectors or any other technicalities related to those. They've been our support partners ever since.
Hi guys, Suresh here, and I think let Kunal finish his presentation, and if there's anything that I think I can add to, I'd be happy to add to it. There was a question earlier about how to select the projector brightness in context of screen size. There is a very definite maths to it, but I would rather that, you know, Kunal sort of finishes his presentation and then during the open Q&A, we can address that.
Yes, we will have some time slot for Suresh where, you know, he'll be able to answer all your questions. And I think that will also be a very interesting session towards the end of today. So continuing this is same setup and also along with the projectors, we can the cropping and all the other features of watch out can be taken with the LED as well as with the projectors. So the multiple screen, multiple images, as well as everything. For outdoor or very large scale mapping events, 20,000 or even 30,000 lumens projectors are used. Whereas if it's a very small mapping, if you're trying to map a book or a shoe or something, you could also use 3000 or 5000 lumens projectors. So it is not that, you know, as soon as you have the word mapping, you need 20,000 lumens. It totally depends upon the surface area to be mapped. So after the projector, the other parameter that we discussed is what is the kind of viewing distance that we have between the projector and the screen. And this is all to do with, you know, optics, just like we have our DSLR cameras and we've got multiple lenses on our cameras, our wide angle lenses, or if we're doing fashion photography or wildlife photography, we've got those tele-zoom lenses and those long lenses. So very similarly, even with projectors, we've got different kinds of lenses that we can use. Just to categorize four main lenses, one is the normal lens, which come as a standard accessory with most of the projectors, which could be a 1.5:1 or a 2:1 lens. They come as a ratio. So it is usually 1.5, say 1.8 or a 2:2.4, but we'll keep it simple. So I'll just say it as, you know, 1.5:1 lens or a 2:1 lens. A standard short throw lens, which we've been using for ages, is a 0.8:1 lens. Then telephoto lenses could be anywhere between 2.4 or a 4.8 onwards. So these are all, and even others are in the category of telephoto lenses. Whereas ultra short throw lenses could be, you know, about 0.25 to 0.4 or a 0.5:1. We'll come to the calculation. This might be sounding too much of math, but we'll try to explain you in an easy way.
Yeah, I think if we could kind of just simplify.
I know. So this is just to mention the optics, and then we coming to the calculation. Now, typically a normal, we take a standard size as 10 feet width. So for a 10 feet width in a 4:3 ratio, we have 7.5 feet height. If we have a 1.5:1 lens, very easily 10 × 1.5 is 15 feet. So 15 feet is the distance that we will need from the screen to the lens of the projector. Plus maybe about 1 or 2 feet additional is your size of the projector. So the simple calculation is whatever is your lens ratio. So width of the screen into this. These are for standard. Now, if you have something which is a vertical or a very long a vertical image, then it could be differently. But we're talking about very standard applications. There can always be exceptions. So for a 10 feet width, if we have a 1.5 lens, we would need 15 feet. Similarly, if we have a 0.8 lens, so 10 × 0.8, so we need 8 feet from the projector. Now, for all the optional lens, which projectors where we need to use an optional lens, it is essential that we keep the projector perpendicular to the screen. Perpendicular meaning right in the center. With the new age projectors, there are also options where they are not interchangeable lenses, and the lenses come with the projectors. So there we'll get the keystone correction. But wherever we have the interchangeable lenses, there the keystone correction is usually not available with the projector itself. So we need to give that kind of height. Otherwise, we would have problem. A small example that if we have if we have about an 8 feet high screen and we have the screen is say 6 feet above, so 8 and 6, 14 feet. So the projector will have to be 6 feet is below and upper aunt may say 4 feet. So about 10 feet elevation is where the lens needs to be. Otherwise, we'll not be able to do the correction for this.
Right. So that's an important guys. Please calculate, you know, the height and the distance from the lens. Always calculate it from the lens on the center of the screen. So Kunalji, can we take in some questions here? There are a lot of questions.
Just one more. We'll finish the telephoto and the ultra short throw, and then we'll take the question. So a typical example of a telephoto lens is, we've all been to cinema theaters where the projector is at the rear end of the cinema, and where your distance could be much. So if your screen is say 30 feet and your distance could be say about 100 to 120 feet distance. Also, if you're doing an event where in your banquet hall, if you're doing front projection, maybe your you have a 20 feet screen, but we don't have the distance or front projection is not possible over there. So we keep the projector at the other end of the banquet hall, which could be about 80 feet or 100 feet. So for things like that, we will need to use telephoto lenses, and these are mainly used for front projection. So for a 10 feet image, if we have a 4:1 lens, then it would be 40 feet. For a 20 feet, if we have a 5:1 lens, then it could be about 100 feet. So then this is the ultra short throw. Ultra short throw is it's essentially something like a fisheye lens. So this is used when we have a very small venue and you know the projector is installed just very close to the projector is very close to the screen or just above the screen. The standard projectors where we have these ultra short throw lenses is about 3000 to 3500 lumens. The lens ratio is about 0.25, say like 0.4. This can be used for you know front, back or top projection. And the companies would normally recommend about 8x6 because going anything higher than that, there could be some kind of a distortion since this is a wide angle lens. Of course, when we use these ultra short throw with professional projectors and professional lenses, we can have bigger images, but here we are talking about the conference room projectors. And these are some examples for the ultra short throw lens installations. Yes, we can take the questions for the projectors.
There are a whole lot of you know questions. The first one from Sushant, but you know there are a lot of agencies here as well, Kunalji and Sureshji. I'd like you also to come in here, please. There's a lot of detailing about projection here. You know, everyone's not from a metro city, so even from smaller cities. So his question is, you know, how do we kind of check the quality of a projector? Is there any way to check the bulb lifespan? Because the smaller guys don't know how many hours they have typically run their projectors. So for a layman, is there any way to cross-check when you're doing a multi-city event in smaller towns, smaller cities, to cross-check the quality or the bulb life of any projector?
There are different kinds of projectors. The earlier projectors were all lamp-based, and these days we have the laser projectors as well. For lamp-based projectors, the companies would say that you know, the lamp life is about 2,000 hours. But by our practical experience, for to get a 5,000 lumens projector to for a 5,000 lumens projector to give the output like 5,000 lumens, usually, after about 400, 500 hours, the brightness of the lamp it deteriorates. So, beyond 500 hours, I would not really. So, if you have a 5,000 lumens projector which is used for over 500 hours, I think you will be able. You would be getting about 3,000 or 4,000 lumens. Also, for the lamp-based projectors, mainly the LCD projectors, once you use the lamp, if you put your new lamps, maybe second time, third time, your brightness will not really be as good. So as long as we can get new projectors, it is ideal. Even if it is not new projectors, we need to check what is the lamp life. And if possible, go to the vendor's warehouse and do a personal checking. But otherwise, it will become very difficult for us to be able to ascertain that, you know, instead of you ordering for an 8,000 lumens projector, what is the actual brightness that you will be getting out of the projector.
Right. So there's another question, very similar question from another person. His name is not mentioned here, but basically he's talking about when he's using multiple projectors, how he's getting different color tones. So I think it could again be the lamp life typically or the projector settings.
Yeah, the lamp life, the way it is used, because most of the projectors are not meant for outdoor application. When you use your indoor projector for some outdoor presentation, there is a lot of dust which goes into the projector, which will also hamper the image picture quality or the image quality. And then we could see some dots or, you know, the softness on the, also the optics of the lens. If the lens is very old or if there is some kind of a moisture or fungus on the lens, even that will impact.
So is there also an average lens life typically? Or, I mean, apart from the lens having scratches, is there a life like the bulb has a life or not really?
Yes, because see, these are optics and all of these will have. So over a certain period of time, the lenses tend to get a little softer. So I don't think we would be able to use lenses for over 5 years.
Right. Okay. So 5 years is the average lens. It's
three,
life.
3 to 5 years. Beyond those, I'm sure we'll not be able to get the same kind of sharpness from the lenses.
Right. You know, this quick question from Dominic.
Lenses as well.
A quick question from Dominic. While we're always talking about the projector, we're talking about the lens, the bulb. You know, nobody talks about the screen quality, you know, especially it's very important to use a good screen quality. So can you throw some light on that? Yes. Because typically if we give the screens to a fabricator, we get very thin quality screens, which are actually used more for decor work. And those don't really have a very good, you know, they don't really attract the projector very well.
Correct. I'm glad Dominic brought this point out, because a lot of people do keep asking these questions, that are there different materials for front and back projection? Firstly, let me tell you that there are different materials. The front projection, the screen material has to be reflective, Whereas for back projection, the material has to be translucent, which will throw the light on the other side. So if you see it from the wrong side, you will only see about 30-40% of the picture quality. Also, we've had experiences where, you know, people are not carrying front projection screens. So they will use a back projection screen, and then on the other side, they will put a kala kapda so that the light will not go on the other side. This is wrong because the light is already transmitted to the other side, and the black cloth will only absorb that light. It will not reflect it back. So right. we'll use at least 50-60% of the picture quality if we're using the wrong screen. So it is essential that we use the right kind of screen. Also, if we use a flex instead of a front screen, you will get a hotspot, and the flex is not the best reflective material. So to get 100% quality, we need to use the right screen. And there are different manufacturers which make specialized screens for projections.
So guys, try and use the screen for the black borders. Those are the original screens, which work very well, and probably they should be of a particular GSM. Quickly, there are some other questions. So from Mayur, Mayur wants to know, are there different lenses for front projection and back projection?
No, they're the same.
They're absolutely the same.
Projectors are the same, lenses are the same.
Right.
There are only settings on the for front, back, top or bottom.
Okay, excellent. So Rahul Agarwal wants to know, how do you actually, when there's a really large screen or you're doing a custom size screen, how do you actually determine what projectors are required? Do you put them into a software and determine that? How exactly can you throw some light on how we can go about that?
No, we did talk about, you know, the recommended sizes of a screen vis-a-vis the projector. But suppose we're doing something like a mapping or...
Absolutely.
Yeah, or if we're doing something like a customized, like the example that we took, which was something like a 50 feet by 16 feet screen or something, then we need to use very high brightness projectors. But otherwise, standard about your 3 to 10,000 lumens projector should be good enough for conference projections. And when we are doing multiple screens with edge blending, that depends upon the sizing.
Right. All right. Some people are asking questions on mapping. So I think Santosh again wants to know, in exhibitions, doing projection mapping is a big issue because there's a lot of ambient light.
Are we coming to mapping? So if we can do that when we are actually addressing
Sure, absolutely. So I think we're good with these questions right now. Of course, there are a lot of questions around mapping. There are a lot of other small questions here and there. There are a lot of questions on font sizes, but I believe we're going to take that up further on.
Yeah. So we're doing font sizing and we're doing mapping in the later part. So these are, you know, main conference room and main conference projectors we were discussing over at this point. So I think we've covered that and we need to move ahead.
Great. Are you going to be covering laser projection, Kunalji, further?
No, laser is only the form. So earlier we had the lamp-based projectors and now we have the laser projectors. Mm-hmm. The lamp, so unlike a lamp projector, which the lamp life was about 2000 hours, the laser projectors are supposed to give us about 20,000 hours of life.
Right. Okay.
So and it's much sharper. And
sharper recently,
we have about 10,000 lumens laser projectors. And recently we did some film screening at this Royal Opera House, where we had an image of about 30 feet by 17 feet, and we had a really good image. This is mainly because it was totally controlled. There was total darkness, so which is why we could get so much of such a big image from a 10,000 lumens. Otherwise, for an outdoor venue or for a conference, if we need such a big image, we would need to use something like an 20,000 lumens. But because the lighting was totally controlled, we could do that with a 10,000 lumens.
Right. A quick question from Hussein Indorwala. Most of us have experienced that a picture output on a normal projector and after we put a short throw lens is very different. You know, there are issues sometimes the minute you put a short throw lens. So how can we kind of, you know, dodge this?
Yeah. That's a good question.
Yes, very pertinent.
Yes, regarding the wide-angle lenses, any time that we choose to use a wide-angle lens, we would have about, say, at least 30% loss of picture quality and sharpness. So whenever we need to use such a wide-angle lens, we need to keep that kind of provision and go in for a one-step higher projector, because it is by default your normal 5,000 lumens. If you're using a 5,000 lumens with a normal lens, and that same 5,000 lumens projector, if you use it with a wide-angle lens, there will be a much bigger drop in the picture quality. And that is because of the optics of the projector. It has got nothing to do with that projector kharab hai. But with the wide angle lens, there is bound to be a picture quality, an image quality drop. It's a characteristic of the lens.
Nitin Pandya wants to know, any mirror projection as an option for short throw or ultra short throw lenses?
Yes, this is what we used to do when there were no short throw and ultra short throw projectors. So that is when we used mirror. Even now, when you see the ultra short throw lenses, there is a built-in mirror. So the output from the lamp, it goes into the mirror, and from the mirror it goes onto the screen. So that is the technicality which the projector will have. But before this, we used to have mirrors. So if there was not sufficient distance, you would actually carry a big mirror, maybe about a 5 feet by 5 feet or a 8 feet by 6 feet mirror onto the venue. We would project on the mirror, and through the mirror, we would project on the screen if we had very less distance.
Right. So let's carry on, Kunalji. And I think the slide you're showing right now is a typical example of what many of us face when it comes to our client logos. Many times the client comes and says, you know, my logo is out of proportion a little bit. It's too much in width. It's too much in height. You know, it's a little off. And I think this is a classic example of what you've shown.
So we understand, we need to understand that, you know, the client has just given one logo or one image, and we see it very differently for different events. So, you know, depending upon your same logo, if we have got different kinds of screen sizes, we are seeing the logo differently, which is very wrong. Because the logo has to be seen the same irrespective of the size of the screen. So, you know, we need to understand why does this happen and how can we not let this happen. So what do display devices have to do with ratios? All display devices, you know, have got to do with aspect ratios. Display device is all about aspect ratios.